Hey WILDR folks, Alicia here. We've got today's leg burner. It's 4 exercises. We're gonna do it as quickly as we can. However, we're gonna prioritize proper technique while we're at it. The wind is blowing a little bit crazy today, so I hope that that doesn't interfere with the audio. If it does, please bear with me, and please do this one along with me as well. So let's talk about the exercises we are going to do before we get into this. Exercise number one is going to be a front squat with leg lift. So I want you to hold some sort of weight. I've got 15 pounds here. If you've got something that weighs a little bit, possibly like a soup pot, so that you can hold the handles on the side, or really anything that you can hold one hand each and hold it up here. We're gonna do a squat. So same thing as always, we're driving our big toe, little toe and heel into the ground. Chest is tall and you're trying to get your heels or your hips as close as you can to your heels and then raise up with knees tracking over that outside toe. So I don't want you to feel like your knees are caving in. I want you to feel like you're trying to put out a cigarette with each foot as you're standing there. So that's what it would be if we let our foot move, but instead we're doing it with locking that heel into the ground. So we're gonna do a front squat, and at the top we're gonna lift one leg. So we'll end up doing 5 per side here. Your core needs to stay tight because you're cantilevering all of your body out over one leg as you do that leg lift. So hips don't shift, we stay super centered and the one knee comes up towards the sky. 5 of those per side, so 10 total. That's exercise number one. Exercise number two is going to be our skier abs. So what you're gonna do is have your hands in a plank position, legs are out behind you. You're jumping both feet to one side and then back to the start. For this one, I really want you to get those feet almost right beside your hands. Use your core to bring those feet forward. 5 per side or 10 total of those. Then we get to go into our kneel to squats. So I finished doing my skier abs. I'm gonna be kneeling. I go 1 foot up, other foot up, first foot down, other foot down. I get to do 5 of these on side number one. And then I'm gonna go other direction. It's kind of funny. Going the direction you're not used to or the direction that's not natural to you is gonna feel kind of weird. So don't worry if one or two of them end up going the wrong way. We're gonna finish with sumo squat jumps. So you'll pick up your weight again if you're feeling really strong with those front squats, and you're gonna sink down, get airborne, and land really softly. Pretend that you are trying not to wake someone who's sleeping right there when you do these ones. That's gonna protect your knees. So quiet landings, 10 of these jumps. Okay, I know that's a lot of talking, but I want you to make sure that you know exactly how to do these properly so that we get the right effect for today's burner. Let's find that clock and let's do this together. Okay, I got the clock. One more time. Starting with our cantilevered front squats, going into our skier abs, then kneeling to squats, and finally finishing up with your squat jumps. Okay, enough avoidance, let's get to the main event. 3, 2, 1, and we're off to the races. Let's do 10 of those cantilevered squats. Good, still getting full extension through this leg that's still on the ground. 10, good, 10 skier abs now. So I'm in the front, hands come right, feet come right in line with my hands, trying to keep my hips low so I get more ab work there. All right, kneeling to squats, 5 per side, 1, 2, 3. 4, 5. Other way, leading with that other foot, then that other foot comes down first. 2, 3, 4, 5. Awesome, and now we get to do our jumps. Bringing those hips down below your knee crease. 5, 6, 7, done. Nice work, that was a tough one. All right, in your program, I have told you how much rest to take, and then we get to repeat this bad boy.